Hey guys, and welcome back to my channel. For today, we are doing another Lana Del Rey guitar tutorial. Ooh, ring got stuck to the string. Oh my god, rhymes. You haven't seen my channel before. My name is Bethy. I do covers, original music, and so much more, and it would mean the world if you subscribed. My last Lana Del Rey tutorial I did back last June.
That is so insane. How did you go like that?
Basically, I did a guitar tutorial to Lana Del Rey's Born to Die, and it got a lot of views, like 17,000 views. So thank you guys so much. Today I'm bringing you West Coast, which was one of my favorite Lana Del Rey songs of all time. But I want to disclaim this by saying I am not a guitar teacher, nor am I a professional in any way. This song is 100% easy for beginners. If you want to see another Lana Del Rey one, because clearly you guys loved it, then we could maybe go in order of her albums, because I did Born to Die, now I'm doing Ultraviolence. I believe the next one is Honeymoon. Also stream my song White Shadow and all of that in my link tree down below. I got this tab from ultimateguitar.com. The exact tab that I'm using for this video, I will link it down below so you guys could like follow along. I also have the chords down below. You're going to have your capo on the second fret. I think I've showed you guys right here. So when you put your capo on the second fret, you're basically now making this your first fret, this your second. You're changing the nut of your guitar, which I told you guys in the last one. And I just have my guitar like refurbished. Like I had her deep cleaned and restrung, and she's so beautiful. It's so funny though, because usually when I did that back home, I would go in and out in like 15 minutes. And then now that I moved to LA, I had to like wait and call, and it took a long time. And I was like, oh my God, is it because there's so many musicians in LA? There are four chords in Miss West Coast. E minor, D, you're like, please get on with it, girl, shut up. C, and A minor. But the E minor is gonna be your first chord in your intro. So E minor is on the second fret, and it is the fifth and fourth string. Then we have D, and for D, you are supposed to play only the last four strings. So it's gonna be the second fret on the first and third string, and then the third fret on the second string. Okay, then we have C. We love a C. If you know me, all my original songs have every form of C in the world. Okay, so we have first fret on the second string, second fret on the fourth string, and third fret on the fifth string. Then last one we have is A minor. For A minor, we have first fret, second string, second fret, third and fourth string. This is an up close of E minor. D, C, and A minor. If you'll notice for the A minor, super easy switch. One finger. The intro with this song on acoustic is interesting because you can't really have an intro because it goes doo-doo, 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 doo-doo. Like, do you know what I mean on the drums? Like, it's super powerful and then it goes ding, 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 and then it has like that. Oh my God, I'm so professional. The Ultimate Guitars, they literally only have the intro as E minor. So it's gonna be down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up. Which is kind of a classic strumming pattern. Down on the West Coast, they got the saying, if you're not drinking, then you're not playing, but you've... Then it goes to D. You stay on E minor for the entire time until she goes, but you've got the music in you. Which you can kind of tell because obviously the notes change, so. Down on the West Coast, they've got a saying, if you're not drinking, then you're not playing, but D, D. But you've got the music, still D. You've got the music in you. C, don't you? That's it, and then repeat. Down on the West Coast. So they literally just have E minor, D, C for really most of all of the verse. A minor only comes in the chorus, so we're chilling. So I'm gonna speed up the strumming a little bit. So, and then it literally just repeats for the second one. So
down on the West Coast, I get this feeling like it all could happen. Silly minor, that's why I'm leaving you.
Where are we going?
You for the moment, you for the moment, boy blue.
C, that's when you jump up. don't you? And then stay there, and then you guys know it goes E minor. I'm feeling hot at the show, I'm feeling hot to the touch. You say you miss me and I do, you say I miss you so much. But something keeps me really quiet, see? I'm alive, I'm a lush. Then it goes to D halfway through. That's the only one where it changes because it just adds pizzazz. I mean, like, you could stay on C, but it'd be really boring, and so it does have a jump. So, something keeps me really quiet. I'm alive, I'm a lush. D. Your love, your love, your love. And those are the same three chords, just you do it small. So it goes E minor, your love, D, your love, C, your love. And then you're gonna go. So then to kind of keep how you know West Coast goes, you don't have to do that, but it's super easy. You literally just press down on C three times. Because it just adds the West Coast theme. Do kind of how at the beginning I was trying to, because I think that drum sequence in the beginning is so powerful. And one of the reasons why getting into the song is good, it completely changes the instrumentals. So when you're playing it on acoustic guitar, you're just kind of strumming that E minor, but you can add a like a harmony. I get so excited when I think about building a song. I'm like, whoo! I want to learn how to play the drums more than anything in my entire life. Like, I can't even explain how badly I want to play the drums. I'm just not in a point in my life right now where I can have a drum set. Whenever a song has a drum sequence, I have this urge and this innate part of me that is saddened. I can't do it. So if I can recreate it on the guitar, mediocre, I'm going to. And then on the last one, you hit A minor. So, ta, 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 ta. Good, sweet, and then it goes into the chorus. But why don't we play the verse all the way through? Here we go. So it starts on E minor. Kind of do down, up, down, down, up, down, up. Just kind of play with it for the intro, and I would just go into it. So ready?
Down on the West Coast, they got a saying. Stay. If you're not drinking, then you're not playing. But you've got the music, D. You've got the music, C in you.
When you go up,
don't you?
Back to that E minor, repeat.
Down on the West Coast, they got a feeling like it all could happen. That's why I'm leaving, D. You for the moment, you for the moment, but look, yeah, you
stay there. You repeat.
Feeling hot at the show, I'm feeling hot to the touch. You see, you miss me, and I do. I see, I miss you so much. But something keeps me really quiet. See, I'm alive, I'm a lush. D, your love. E, your love. D, your love.
C. And when I said E, I meant E minor. And then we're gonna just smack that baby three times, head on over to A minor, and then you're ready to be in the chorus.
Dun, 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 dun.
To A minor. Ultraviolence is absolutely incredible. The idea of like a sad girl in blue jeans, and we want to make sure we portray her message through our cover. Here we go. You never know what she's seeing, guys. You never know. Also, at my work, my boss told me that Lana is a regular, and so I am just waiting for the day where I make a video of my experience meeting Lana Del Rey, and I will tell her how much she inspires me with music, so she could see this tutorial. Lana, if you're watching this, hi! We're going to do the chorus, and the chorus is fun, and the good thing is, you know, there's two parts, they're both exactly the same. So we love that. So we're gonna start off with, so we just went from to A minor.
I can see my baby swinging
to C.
His parliament's on fire and his hands are up on the balcony.
So that one line does have three chord changes, but they're super easy. So it's A minor, D, A minor. Okay, so
his parliament's on fire and his hands are up.
A minor.
On the balcony.
D.
And I'm singing, move, baby.
that chord also has three, that last sentence also has three chord changes, and they're the same except instead of A minor at the end, it's C. And that's gonna be the end of the verse. So it's, on the balcony, we're at D, and I'm singing A minor D, then to C. And then you know how it has a, I'm in love, and then it moves on to the verse? That's gonna be E minor. So, on the balcony, and I'm singing, move, baby, I'm in love. E minor. I'm in love. Kind of just strum that off the distance. And guess what? Do you remember what our verse started with, the chord? E minor! So we can literally just stay there. So then it repeats just like the verse at the start. Starts with E minor.
Down on the west coast, they got their icons. They're silver starlets, they're queens of Saigons. And you, remember D, got the music. You got the music in you.
What chord do we go to for you when it goes higher? C.
Don't you?
E minor.
I'm feeling hot in the show. I'm feeling hotter than fire. D. Guess I know I.
To D, and then the three chords. E minor.
Your love's
D.
Your love.
C.
Your love.
Two, three times. A minor. And then we're right back into the chorus. After that, I will repeat the chorus two times. It ends again on
I'm in love.
That E minor. Play those lighter, less intense, because it's supposed to be kind of fading and kind of an after the fact type of point that she's trying to make. We are going to do the play along with me session. You guys said you liked that, which meant so much to me. If this helps, let me know, and thank you guys so much for joining. I love you so much.
Down on the west coast, they've got a saying, if you're not drinking, then you're not playing. But you've got the music, you've got the music in you. Yeah, you. Down on the west coast, they got a feeling, it all could happen, that's why I'm leaving you. Don't you? You're pushing on a blue wheel.
Bye guys, I love you.
Bye guys, I love you.